Today we'll discuss about the nutritional assessment. So why the nutritional assessment is important? Nutritional assessment is done to identify or to detect any kind of nutritional problems. So nutritional problems is occur because of the excessive consumption of nutrients, or else it is occur because of the deficiency of particular nutrient. So to detect the deficiency or to detect the excessive consumption, we should undergo for the nutritional assessment. So what's come under the nutritional assessment? First, we will see the definition of nutritional assessment. So a nutritional assessment is a comprehensive analysis of a person's nutritional status. Okay, a comprehensive analysis, that means we are looking towards all the aspects of the person's nutritional status. Okay, we are doing comprehensive, we are doing thorough examination of the individual's nutritional status that uses historical information, food intake data, anthropometric measurements, physical examination, and the biochemical data. Okay, with the taking full thorough history of the person, by doing the analysis of the food intake data, by doing their anthropometric examination, checking their height, weight, head circumference, chest and midarm circumference, we are doing the nutritional assessment. The nutritional status of an individual is often the result of many interrelated factors. Okay, nutritional status is affected by the many factors. The factors are interrelated with each other. It is influenced by food intake, quantity, quality, and physical health. So the nutritional status is affected by the food intake, the quantity of food you are taking, what quality of food you are taking, and the physical health of the individuals. The spectrum of the nutritional status spread from obesity to severe malnutrition. Spectrum of the nutritional status, that means a problem related to the nutritional status is spread over to the various area. It is starting from the obesity, that means excessive weight gain, to the malnutrition. So there are certain kind of malnutrition, especially the protein energy malnutrition, which is very common in the children. The protein energy malnutrition is involving two characteristics, that is marasmus and quaxiopor. In the quaxiopor, there will be the deficiency of protein is visible, whereas in the marasmus, there will be the deficiency of both protein and calories found in the children. So this is one of the major problem of the children. Now, purpose of nutritional assessment. Why we are performing, and what is the purpose of performing such kind of nutritional assessment? First purpose is identify individuals or population groups at risk of becoming malnourished. So in the nutritional assessment, we are doing the survey so that we can come to know about the nutritional problems in the population, and we can give the knowledge to the people so that they are aware of the nutritional problem and they can protect themselves by getting any kind of problem. So we should identify the people and the population by doing the nutritional assessment. Moreover, we should identify individuals or a population group who are malnourished. So by doing the nutritional assessment, we can come to know about the percentage of the malnutrition among the population. The third purpose is to develop healthcare programs that meet the community needs which are defined by the assessment. Okay, if you have done the nutritional assessment and you can come to know about that the so many people are suffering from malnutrition, obesity or the anemia, so that you can able to develop, you can plan some of the healthcare program so that the people of our country use that program and they can improve their health status. To measure the effectiveness of the nutritional programs and interventions was initiated. Okay, so in the survey, we have identified the problems of the nutrition in the population. So to solve that problem, we have launched certain kind of healthcare programs. Now the fourth purpose is whether their health programs are beneficial for the population or not. We have to check the effectiveness of the nutritional program and the interventions once they were started. Now, the nutritional assessment aids in identifying. So, if you are doing the nutritional assessment, what things you can identify? First and foremost, that is undernutrition. If you are doing the survey, you are taking the history from the person, you are doing the anthropometric examination, biochemical test, physical examination. So, by doing this all kind of assessment, we can come to know about the underweight or the undernutrition among the children. Same, we can also able to know about the overnutrition and some of the nutritional deficiency. So there are so many nutritional deficiencies are there. Very common is the PEM, protein energy malnutrition. Then the micronutrient deficiency, that means the deficiency of vitamins and the minerals. Next, we can come to know about the person at risk of the developing malnutrition. Person at risk of developing nutrition related disease, the resources available to assist them to overcome the nutritional problem. So by doing the nutritional assessment, we can come to know about the risk of malnutrition, we can come to know about the risk of developing any kind of other nutritional problems, as well as by the nutritional assessment, we can come to know about what resources are available to us and how we can use that resources to treat the nutritional problems. Now the methods of nutritional assessment. So as you can see, there are two methods of nutritional assessment, direct method and indirect method. Direct method, in that we are directly approached to the person and we are making the nutritional assessment. Indirect method, that means we are not doing face-to-face assessment, we are going towards the records, we are going towards the register, we are analyzing the statistical data and we can come to know about the nutritional status of the people. So direct, that means face-to-face we are doing the assessment. Indirect, that means we are going towards the secondary source of information and we are making the predictions. First, there is a direct method of the nutritional assessment. So in the direct method, there are four types are there: nutritional anthropometry, biochemical and biophysical test, clinical assessment, dietary evaluation and the methods. So anthropometric examination involving examination of height, examination of weight, head circumference, chest circumference and the medium circumference. Biochemical and biophysical tests are involving blood test, urine test, stool test and the biophysical test involving the USG, CT scan, X-ray and so on. Next one is the clinical assessment, that is a head to toe examination. So in the head to toe examination, from starting from head to the toe, we are doing the assessment. So under the direct method of the nutritional assessment, there will be the nutritional anthropometry, biochemical or biophysical test, clinical assessment and dietary evaluation method. So to easily remember, you should know the ABCD. A is for anthropometric examination, B is for biochemical or biophysical test, C is for clinical assessment and D is for the dietary evaluation. So the anthropometric test involving examination of height, examination of weight, head circumferences, chest circumferences and medium circumferences. So by doing assessment of all these four parameters, we can come to know about the nutritional status of the people. Next is the biochemical and biophysical test. So in that biophysical and biochemical test, we are doing the examination or of the blood test, urine test, stool test and the biophysical involving the machineries, which is involving X-ray, ultrasonography and so on. Next is the clinical assessment, in that we are doing head to toe assessment, and last one is the dietary evaluation, in that we are doing evaluation of the dietary pattern. Next is the indirect method, in that three types are there: assessment of socio-economical status, vital statistics of community and ecological variables including crop production. So these three methods are indirect method of the nutritional assessment. So we are doing socio-economical status assessment. Example, if the socio-economical status is high, or the if the person is rich, their nutritional status is good. But they are, if they are poor, they are not able to purchase the food, and they may lead to the nutritional problems. Moreover, vital statistics of the community. So the statistical data we can look and we can come to know about the proportions of the nutritional problems, and the ecological variables are also involved, and they are also helping for the nutritional assessment. Thank you.